I want you to listen closely to this next announcement, because it's about somebody who has given her life for you guys. I'd love to really have the room get really quiet for this. I would love to have you listen. Thank you. I want you to hear this. I don't want you to, it's not me being funny, it's me being respectful to somebody who could be called the First Lady of ASCAP Film and TV. And she has no idea we're doing this. When Nancy Knudsen came to ASCAP in 1988, aren't you glad you quieted down now? When Nancy Knudsen came to ASCAP in 1988, the film and television department was essentially a party of one. She helped to become the critically important part of ASCAP that it is today and developed many of the film TV traditions we hold most dear, including our prestigious film scoring workshop and this very award show. And I have to tell you that if you lined up all the things that ASCAP does, if there's one thing that I could hold up as a shining example of ASCAP at its best, it would be the film and TV workshop. It's brilliant, it's hard work, and the people that put it together have given the world a great gift. Nancy has never flagged in her deep admiration and advocacy for composers. We all wanted to take this opportunity to thank you, Nancy, for everything you've done over the years. Everything you've done. Because of Nancy Knudsen, we will always remember that the C in ASCAP stands for composers. To help honor Nancy for her many years of service to ASCAP, I want to introduce an old friend and mentor of hers. Ladies and gentlemen, is the first gentleman that ever gave me a job writing for a movie. He is Mr. John Williams.
Thank you all so much. How nice is that? Thank you. Well, you are really nice. Let me just quickly give you an idea of the atmosphere at the Boston Symphony, where Nancy began her career. The Symphony is a busy organization with a full season for the orchestra itself, plus the Boston Pops, and a 10-week summer festival at Tanglewood that is similar in scale and quality to the Hollywood Bowl. It was and is a busy place. And when I first went to Boston in the late 1970s as a guest conductor, I noticed a diminutive little lady, very young, who seemed to be everywhere at once. And I certainly noticed her, but I don't remember whether we met at that time or not. When I went back to Boston in 1980 to become the permanent conductor of the Boston Pops, Nancy seemed by osmosis to have been assigned to me as my assistant. And we did 4 to 5 concerts a week during that period, a weekly PBS television show, and endless recordings for Philips and Sony. And Nancy seemed magically to make all of this happen. She set up schedules of all kinds, like choral rehearsals, piano rehearsals, orchestra rehearsals, camera rehearsals. She attended long meetings on programming and repertoire, and could be relied upon always to correctly spell Koussevitzky, Shostakovich, and she knew the 3 acceptable spellings for Tchaikovsky. She coordinated travel concerning a long list of guest artists who sometimes could be temperamental, but who all became in love with Nancy. And at this busy time, I was working on a Star Wars episode that introduced fuzzy little creatures called Ewoks. and the little Ewok quickly became my nickname for Nancy. And fortunately, unlike diamonds, the quality of people isn't measured by their size. And in Nancy's case, the quality component is huge. Sadly for Boston, she moved to Southern California and made a remarkable contribution to this great organization while making musical friends all around the world. So for me, it's a particular pleasure tonight to join with all of you in honoring my friend, my favorite little Ewok, and a very great lady. Please join me as we honor Nancy Knutson.
Wow, this is a very, very big surprise. And while I'm used to speaking publicly, as you, most of you know, I don't always like it when the attention is on me. But I just have to say that my entire career has been spent working with composers, concert composers, film and TV composers, many of whom have become great friends. And I couldn't have asked for a better career, a better job than this job at ASCAP. And I don't know what else to say, except I'm going to enjoy the rest of the evening, and maybe next year I won't have to do anything at all at any award shows. Okay. Thanks.